Hello students, welcome back to our class. Okay, see, today we are going to start our new lesson, importance of transport system. Okay, all you have to open the page number 95. Okay, see, importance of transport system. Transport system, which is taking the people from one place to another place. Another place, even not only the people, even goods, but passing one place to another place, okay, that we are calling as transport system. The importance, okay, importance of that transport system we have to know now, okay. See, can you guess what is the importance? Maybe see, for example, if there is no transportation system, how we will get the goods whichever we are using now? See, we are using a daily basis, many goods we are using, many products, okay, from morning to the night we are using many products. How it will be reached to us? If the industries were some far away to our villages, can we go to the industries to buy each and every product? No, we are not going. No, it is available in our places. How does it happens? Due to the transport system, whatever the produced by the industries, that is transported to the market areas, and market is from the markets and wholesalers, the retailers and kirana shops, they will be brought, okay, and they are keeping us very near to us, and we are going and buy and we are using, okay. And if we want to be go and watch any other persons, okay, if you want to be meet any other person, how will go? Can we go by walk or to the long places? No, by using of any vehicle, we'll go and we'll meet back, and within that day also. Yes or no? So like that, okay. And how the people depending on the transport system, and how many types of the transport systems are there, and how they are deciding which transport system is good for the transport at that times, okay? That all we are going to know now, okay? We are going to know now, okay? And see here, the first topic is transport system in Telangana, okay? First topic is transport system in Telangana. See here, how many transport systems are there in Telangana? Roadways, roads, railways, airways, waterways. Yes or no? Do we have the airports? Yes. Do we have the waterways? Of course, for our Telangana, there is no waterways or transport systems. Okay. Okay. See, it is not about the Telangana, but see here, railways, roads and airways. Okay. Do we have the railway systems? Yes, we have. Near our school only we have one railway station also. Yes or no? Right. So about this all, okay, about this all we are going to know now detail. See, this is all nothing but, of course, generally you might have know about this, okay. See, roads. Okay, roads. See, these roads facilities and keeping of all the roads, it's all responsibility by the government, okay. So if it is the village roads, that responsibility done by the village panchayat levels. In the urban areas, that responsibility by urban municipality commissions and all, okay. And borders also having the roads, that all responsibility by the government, okay, that state government. And national wise, which is connecting to the state, okay, they are giving the name as national highways, okay, which is connecting the roads from the state to states, the name they are denoting, okay, national highways. Here I have written one national highway number, which is that NH 44. Why? Because this NH 44, it is connecting many states. How many states you know? See, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. See, these road is, these NH highway, National Highway 44 number, it's connecting many states. It's very big roadway. Okay, see, and next about the railways. See, in our India, most of the people depends on the transportation system, especially the railways. How much, you know, 1/5 of the travelers are depending on the railway system for their transportation. And as well as even not only the passengers, means not only the people, even for transporting of the goods, okay? Transporting of the goods and products are using the transportation system of railways. See, for example, if you see our Nizamabad railway station, there beside of that two platforms, you can see some of the other track which is beside. There every time uploading of some these bags and some of goods. Especially I have seen that some of fertilizers, okay? And you might have seen, observed that petroleums and oils also, they are exporting. We might have seen some of the trains also, goods trains. So like that. See, not only one type of goods, even petrol, gases and coal, okay? We might have seen many times here, alright? And coal, cement, fertilizers, food grains, iron ore, okay? So these many are transported by the railways. Sometimes vehicles also transported by the railways, okay? Next, coming to airways. Do we have the airways in Telangana? Yes, we have, okay? One international airport we have, that is in Hyderabad, Shamshabad area, okay? That is international airport. And as well as we have some national airport also. In Hyderabad only, that national airport we are calling as another term, domestic airports, okay? In Hyderabad, okay? And in Hyderabad only we have one of the domestic, and they want to be built some of the 6 domestic in our future. And one is very near to our Nizamabad, which is very near to our area, okay? They want to be built in the future. Maybe it will be coming to the next future within 2-3 years. Actually, government have a given plan also for that domestic highway, domestic airways, okay? And waterways. See, in our Telangana, of course, there is no water transportation system, but in AP, it's have a 15 ports. Ports means, don't you think that any another meaning? It's nothing but see, buses where it will be stopped on the roads, that we are calling a bus stop. Trains are stopping place, station, railway stations. Yes or no? Same like that. In the seas and oceans, okay, beach places, where the ships, okay, ships, okay, where the ships will be stops, and where it is imports and exports will be process going on, that places, okay, we are calling as ports. Especially AP is developed in this water-based transportation system. AP have how many ports, you know? 15 ports. Okay? How many ports? 15 ports. Especially these 15 ports are most of these 15 ports are near the Vishakhapatnam. Okay? Vizag, we may can call. Okay? See, and the next topic is use of roads for production and sale of goods. Okay? Use of roads for production and sale of goods. Just now I told you the starting of the lesson. Yes or no? See how it will be used, okay, for the production and sale of the goods. It will be used for farmers, industries, traders and other people like our casual people also, so much useful. Road transportation. How it will be, you know? For example, assume it if it is any industry, okay? So if it is that industry want to be produce any of the product, okay? So for that producing of that product, they need some raw materials, okay? They need some raw materials. Okay, so for that they have to be depend on, for example, if it is any wood to do anything, no, right? So that wood they have to be import from the forest areas or else some other long places. Okay, from there to here, how it will be